As I often do, I was scrolling through Reddit looking for video topics to yoink, and I came across this post. Fake Lubuntu website named lubuntu.net. So we have lubuntu.me here, and then lubuntu.net. This sounded so ridiculous that I had to check it out. And for me, the SEO is a little bit different, but right here, lubuntu.me, scroll down a little bit further, lubuntu.net. To make things clear right off the bat, lubuntu.me is the official Ubuntu website. If you go to the Ubuntu Flavors page, find Lubuntu, where it says Get Lubuntu, this links to lubuntu.me. Now this lubuntu.net domain, this is not new, and this is not the first person who's been confused by it. Back in 2021, lubuntu.net is not the official site. Lubuntu.net versus lubuntu.me. If lubuntu.net is not the official site, why doesn't the Lubuntu project get the website taken down or seize the domain name since they have the official trademark of the Lubuntu project? But those are fairly recent posts. It goes back even further. 8 years ago, lubuntu.me versus lubuntu.net. What's happening? And a bug report on the Lubuntu bug tracker, also back in 2016. Now, I would recommend not going to the lubuntu.net website, because if you go to it right now, uBlock Origin is not happy about you doing so. If we instead go to it in a virtual machine, you're gonna see a very old version of the Lubuntu website and a very old version of the Lubuntu updates. It's saying the latest version is 19.04. with the download page saying the same thing. Now the download is coming from where you would expect it to come from. It is coming from the Ubuntu CD image page. Now, because it's a really old version, that link is now dead, but it did work at one point. So what's the deal with the .NET website then? Well, the first point, let's take a look at the Wayback Machine. The ME domain was started in 2015, but the .NET domain, that started in 2010, and that's because lubuntu.net used to be the official domain of the Lubuntu project. This is before becoming an official Ubuntu flavor when the project was first started by Mario Behling. Okay, that explains why the .NET domain was made, but why in 2015 did they swap to a new one, and why in 2024 is the .NET domain still active and still has a version of the Lubuntu website, albeit an older version? Well, this is where things start getting dumb. Mario left the project. According to maintainers, this was back in 2012. According to some of the stuff we see later, it's more like 2014. Regardless, he left the project. When he left the project, he didn't hand over the lubuntu.net domain. We've had a lot of problems getting anything updated on lubuntu.net. Among other reasons, Mario is always away. No one else has access to the page. The problem has been ongoing for a long time, and we've just put up with it. The fact that a rash of users are complaining about this just illustrates just how much of a problem it is and how we can no longer accept it the way it is. This was back in 2016. And this is why the site was frequently out of date. Back in 2016, it still had the 1504 ISO, even though 1604 was already out. People were really confused because, especially at the time, it was showing up at the top of search results, so people thought it was the official domain. The maintainer not really actively being in the project anymore, the maintainer being impossible to work with, this is what led to the creation of lubuntu.me as a new site that they actually had control of and could actually update and make sure pointed to the correct things. But at the time, lubuntu.me didn't look any more official than the old lubuntu.net site. So they made some minor changes, like saying Lubuntu, the official home of Lubuntu, as the title of the page, and went around changing links, making sure that everything they had access to modify now pointed to the new site, like Wikipedia. They went and made an account on DuckDuckGo to make sure their search was showing the correct things. They got a bang search made on DuckDuckGo that pointed to the new website and just encouraged people to talk about the new website, use the new website, and try to get it higher in the search results. And to make sure this never happened again, when lubuntu.me's domain expired in 2016, instead of being owned by the maintainers of the Lubuntu project, it got transferred over to Canonical, so now they have the domain. But besides just the annoying SEO and the confusion for users, there was also a problem for Canonical. As for Mario, he's using what even Lubuntu.net itself describes as a Canonical trademark. We are currently in conversation with him to redirect or link to Ubuntu.me from Lubuntu.net. However, if he's unwilling or unresponsive, the next step to ensure that our users are happy is to talk to Canonical Legal and let them have at it. One way or another, something will happen. Again, this was in 2016. So let's jump to 2018, the first edition of This Week in Lubuntu Development. The major code that Lubuntu works on is now mirrored on our official GitHub page. We're working on mirroring more useful repositories. Stay tuned. All of our official web presences, meaning Lubuntu.me and subdomains, because Lubuntu.net is no longer under the control of the Lubuntu project, we can't say more at this time, except that we are no way affiliated with FOSS Asia, now have HTTPS, and we have many more ways you can contact us. This is a very important part of the story. FOSS Asia. Now, in September of 2018, someone reached out to one of the Lubuntu maintainers over on IRC. Is there a reason why Lubuntu.net/downloads points to the 1804 images and not to the 18.04.1 ones? This is the old site. We don't control that site. We control Lubuntu.me. Oh. Yup. Whoa's output looks like Lubuntu.me is registered by Canonical. Who is controlling Lubuntu.net? FOSS Asia. They refuse to publish up-to-date content and refuse to work with us. Let's not talk more about this. It's been ongoing for several years, and there's nothing new or nothing anyone can do about it yet. I googled Lubuntu, and Lubuntu.net was the very first hit for me. And we can't control that, unfortunately. Well, you could put some official statement on your Lubuntu.me page, like a tagline saying, the official Lubuntu home, and maybe some longer explainer in the easy-to-find FAQ. Yeah, I can't exactly tell you why we can't do that yet, but an answer is coming. Believe me, as the main developer of Lubuntu, I want to see it solved, but we're working on it. Okay, let's step back just a little bit. Who is FOSS Asia? What is FOSS Asia? Well, this is the FOSS Asia website. It's one of those regional-based organizations for hosting FOSS events. Perfectly fine. Now, let's go to the About section, go to the Team section, and, would you look at that? It's Mario. Now some of those gears might start turning in your head. Why is he talking about FOSS Asia? Well, Mario left the project, still retained the domain, and is now a founder of FOSS Asia. But it goes a bit further than that. So the other founder in 2018 posted this on Twitter. Is making documentation for a free software project an act of copyright and trademark violation? FOSS Asia, Lubuntu, at GitHub plus Twitter shutdown because of infringement claims of GPL Creative Commons license repo. How is it possible? At Canonical, at FSF, hashtag DMCA. This is the messiest tweet I've ever read. So what happened here? Well, I told you it was getting dumb. They got a DMCA claim from presumably Canonical. It doesn't have the name here. Presumably someone on the Lubuntu team who was just done. And they wanted the docs.lubuntu.net pulled down, wiki.lubuntu.net, lubuntu-metapackage, lubuntu-projects, lubuntu-wallpapers, and the main lubuntu-dev account. Now, this is not the main Lubuntu account. This is the FOSS Asia Lubuntu account. And, they sent it. And you know what? It happened. All of it got pulled down, repository unavailable due to DMCA takedown. Now, considering what it says here, I'm assuming that Walter is the person who was on the DMCA claim. Walter was one of the people we saw in that earlier thread. This happening perfectly explains why Simon did not want to talk about this. There was an ongoing legal dispute. He couldn't talk about it.
This is not the end of the story.
Case number D2024-0996. What is that, you might ask? Well, an administrative panel decision from the World Intellectual Property Organization, a subsidiary of the United Nations. And as the name might suggest, they deal with intellectual property issues that go across country borders that are really complex and all of this fun stuff. Now, in this case, it was a matter of Canonical has the Lubuntu trademark. They are running Lubuntu, but there's this other project, FOSS Asia, that has the Lubuntu.net domain that looks like Lubuntu.net, and we want that domain. Now, to make this happen, Canonical had to prove a couple of things. Firstly, the disputed domain name is identical or confusingly similar to a trademark or service mark in which the complainant has rights, and the respondent has no rights or legitimate interest in respect of the disputed domain, and the disputed domain has been registered and is being used in bad faith. All of these things need to be proven. Now, is it confusingly named to make it seem like the Lubuntu trademark? There is a lot of text written here, but yes. Now, the respondent, the people the complaint is being made against, they argue that the Lubuntu trademark is not being held by Canonical in Vietnam. Therefore, they should be able to use it. WIPO says this is not really relevant to this part of the discussion. This is about likelihood of confusion. Geographical trademark location is at a later point in the discussion. To add to this, using the name Lubuntu is also confusingly similar to Ubuntu, which is another trademark held by Canonical. One part is now confirmed. What about registered and used in bad faith? Well, here we have an issue. Lubuntu.net was registered before the Lubuntu trademark was made, and before the Lubuntu.me domain. Also, as the long-term domain holder and continuous operator of Lubuntu.net, I, along with the project team, have been commonly known by the domain name long before any notice of dispute was received. The domain Lubuntu.net has become synonymous with the independent project we created. Also, whilst the domain was transferred from Mario over to FOSS Asia, and usually this would count as a re-registration of the domain and would give Canonical ground to stand on, because Mario is one of the founding members of FOSS Asia, in this case that is waived because he's basically transferring the domain from himself to the organization that he runs. Therefore, the domain was registered before Canonical had any claim over the domain and has been continuously used since then. So, accordingly, the panel finds that the complainant has not established that the disputed domain name was registered in bad faith and therefore has not established the third requirement under the policy. And again, they needed all three of them to be met, so they can't do it. If that was all of it, that would be funny enough. Section D, reverse domain name hijacking. Paragraph 15E of the policy provides that if after considering the submissions, the panel finds the complaint was brought in bad faith, so Canonical making the complaint was in bad faith, for example, in an attempt at reverse domain name hijacking or to harass the domain name holder, the panel shall declare in its decision the complaint was brought in bad faith and constitutes an abuse of the administrating proceeding. The mere lack of success of the complaint is not on its own sufficient to constitute reverse domain name hijacking. But it's certainly a consideration they have. The complainant initiated this proceeding on the basis that it accepted the disputed domain name had been registered in good faith, or which for present purposes amounts to the same thing, with the complainant's permission. The complainant was mistaken about the identity of the registrant, understandably so, given the use of the privacy protection service. However, the complainant did not seek to change the basis of its claim once the identity of the respondent through the registrar's verification response. It merely sought to add the respondent to Mr. Bailing, formerly addressed as a respondent, in the initial complaint. As discussed above, since the rejection of the so-called retrospective registration in bad faith theory advanced in cases such as City Views Limited versus Monica Privacy Services, case number D2009-063, it has long been settled under the policy that registration in bad faith must be demonstrated, not just use in bad faith. For the foregoing reasons, the complaint is denied. Moreover, the panel finds the complaint has been brought in bad faith and constitutes an attempt at reverse domain name hijacking. Basically, what this is saying is the UN has declared that Canonical needs to stop bullying Labunja.net and needs to just let them keep using the domain. This is an absolutely ridiculous situation, but this happened in May of this year. So, I don't know, maybe more stuff happens from now. Maybe we see like a full-on court case between Canonical and FOSS Asia just to get the Labunja.net domain. I have no idea where this is going to go from here. All I know is Labunja.me is the main site and Labunja.net, well, the UN declared they're allowed to keep doing it. But what do you think? Are you a legal expert? I hope you are. You're probably not, though, so you're just going to pretend to be one. Give me your take. Do you think Canonical's in the right? Do you think FOSS Asia's in the right? Are you just sitting back and laughing at this ridiculous situation? I would love to know. So if you like the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe to Liberapay, linked in the description down below. That's gonna be it for me, and I don't know what to say at this point.